afternoon. Today is Thursday, November 7th.
Now over to Jamie with some more announcements.
Thank you. The quote of the day today is, "We're all stories in the end, just make it a good one," by Devin Kay. Lunch for today is chicken Alfredo with a hot combo of rib sandwich. Lunch for tomorrow is a main meal of buckskin bowl with no hot combo. Now over to the weather report.
Cameron, it's rolling.
Today's going to be a high of 57 and a low of 31, and cloudy and rainy. Tomorrow's going to be a high of 42 and a low of 21, and it's going to be sunny out. Now we're to headline news.
Did it crack?
I think.
Did your phone crack?
Oh, a little bit. I broke it playing Quizlet yesterday.
Thanks, Weather Girl. The Los Angeles Times faced fierce backlash for its coverage of the 9 Americans murdered by a Mexican drug cartel this week, after a report highlighted the family's long history of violence. At least 6 children and 3 women living in a faith-based community of U.S. citizens in Mexico were shot to death Monday in the northern part of the country. And 6 more children were wounded after their convoy came under fire during a brazen daylight ambush, believed to have been carried out by gunmen affiliated with cartels. All the victims are believed to be members of the extended LeBaron family, who have lived in a religious community in La Mora, northern Mexico, a decades-old settlement in Sonora State. However, the California newspaper ran a report Monday, headlined, "U.S. victims in Mexico massacre were tied to family with a long history of violence," which detailed the community's tragic past with the cartels. The report sparked a firestorm of criticism on social media. "Is the idea here that the victims had it coming? This is an insane piece," conservative commentator Ben Shapiro reacted. "This story is just terrible. A family is burying small children, and now the media is dredging up completely unrelated events committed by distant relatives that happened more than a generation ago. Nice," the Dispatch senator, editor, David French, wrote. I'm Sophia Steed, reporting.
Attention seniors who have not had your senior portrait taken. Currently, 27 members of the class of 2020 have not had your senior pictures taken for the yearbook. Each of you are mailed a postcard with specific appointment time. Also, the list is posted on the class of 2020 bulletin board outside the cafeteria, on the bulletin board outside the main office. Please check the list for your specific appointment time. Pictures will be taken in the auditorium on Monday, November 18th. This does not cost you anything. You do not have to wear anything special. We want your photo in the yearbook. Now over to Tea with Stevie.
Hey, what's up, CV? Welcome back. For this week's tea, we're going to get the scoop on how people feel about the holiday seasons. So obviously, last month, October, was spooky season, Halloween, woo! But December is Christmas season, and we're all excited for that. Happy holidays! But what about November? You see, is that Christmas season, or Thanksgiving season, or is Thanksgiving only a day and not a season? I don't know. Let's see what CV has to say about this tea.
Do you think that November is Christmas season or Thanksgiving season?
Well, Thanksgiving, no doubt about it.
Why?
Why? Because Christmas is not in November. Christmas is in December. December comes after November. November is first.
That's true, but what do you say for people who are already listening to Christmas music?
They have something mixed up in their internal calendar.
Is there a Thanksgiving season?
Yes.
Yes? When does it start?
We're in it right now.
Okay. So can you listen to Christmas music in Thanksgiving season?
I say no.
think you wait till Christmas music until after Thanksgiving.
In your opinion, is November Thanksgiving season or Christmas season?
Thanksgiving season.
So you think Thanksgiving has a season, it's not just a day?
It's the month of giving.
Do you think that November is Christmas season or Thanksgiving season?
It is Thanksgiving season, and I have a long-standing rule that I will not listen to any Christmas music until December 1st, final.
Okay, so would you say November is like Thanksgiving season then?
November is Thanksgiving season. Look at the hallway. It's Thanksgiving season.
Is there a Thanksgiving season?
No.
No? So are we in Christmas season right now?
No.
No? Then what are we in?
November.
But it's not Thanksgiving season?
No.
Then, what?
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
Is there a Thanksgiving season?
No.
Yeah? When is it? There isn't one. No?
Wait, I don't know.
So is it Thanksgiving or is it Christmas? It's actually Christmas.
In your opinion, is November Christmas season or Thanksgiving season?
Thanksgiving season. It's Thanksgiving season. You know what I'm saying? The baked mac and cheese slaps. Then you gotta have the collard greens, but if you don't got the hog in it, you're doing it wrong. Simple. You know what I'm saying? And then that turkey. Ooh! You know what I'm saying? With the, you know what I'm saying? With the sweet potatoes, the candy yams, especially with the marshmallows and the brown sugar. Yo, just wait. Just wait on it. Just wait on it. Wait on it.
You got me convinced. I'm with you.
Okay, so is there a Thanksgiving season?
From after trick-or-treating till you eat your turkey.
Do you think November is Christmas season or Thanksgiving season?
Christmas season.
Okay, so are you listening to Christmas music and everything a while?
Well, like, no, but I hear it on, like, TV and stuff, and it's cool. It's fun.
Okay, so Thanksgiving is just confined to one day?
Yeah, just to eat.
That makes sense, yeah.
For Thanksgiving season?
Yes.
Spooky season is October. When does Christmas season start? Does it start in November? Does it start in December?
Thanksgiving.
After Thanksgiving. So is there a Thanksgiving season?
No.
No?
It's a holiday.
But it's only a day?
Yeah.
Okay.
Good.
Welcome back, CV.
This week on Tea with CV, we went around this school and asked the student body if you guys think if November is the Thanksgiving season or Christmas season.
Yeah, so a lot of the answers pointed to Thanksgiving season, although there were some Christmas diehard fans that are already listening to Christmas music, as you can see from the interviews. A majority of people just think it's Thanksgiving season and they don't want to skip a holiday. Yep. They want to eat their turkey in peace, wake up from their food coma. Thank you, Rachel, for that. Wake up from their food coma and put their Christmas tree up and start listening to that good old music.
And even on our Instagram story, follow us at TWCV, a lot of people, 62% of people said that it is indeed Thanksgiving season and not Christmas season. Yes. So,
but
final answer.
If you are already listening to Christmas music, that's perfectly fine. I do it too. If you think it's only Thanksgiving season, if that December is Christmas, that's fine too. You know, you do you.
Okay, so I guess that's this week's tea.
See you next week, CV.
Turkey season.
Attention Ceramic 1 and 2 students from Walking Period 1. All work has been fired and is ready to be picked up. Deadline for picking up work is Thursday, November 7th. All ceramic work in the showcase by the main office will be on display until Thanksgiving break. An announcement will be made regarding pickup later this month. If you have any questions or need to make other arrangements, please contact Mrs. Gleason. If you are signed up to watch the performance of Macbeth tomorrow, you will be dismissed at 12:45 from your fourth block class. If you eat D lunch, your fourth block teacher will dismiss you to eat C lunch. Please communicate with your fourth and fifth block teachers that you will be missing part or all of their class. It is your responsibility to make up any missed work. We look forward to seeing you at the performance. Now over to CV Sports.
Attention students in grades 9 through 11 interested in playing football for the 2020-21 school year. Signups are currently taking place. Please stop by Mr. Perry and his office, second floor of Real, room 252, to get an information sheet on the windowsill next to his door. Please fill the sheet out immediately and place it in the yellow folder next to the stack of football sheets.
Attention rifle team members, range setup will be held today immediately after school. All members should attend.
There are no sports for today.
Go home and do your homework.
Now to sports highlights.
Playing together again, this time for Detroit with Patrick Nemeth and Philip Ronick on defense. So let's see. Spun in by Nemeth and stopped by Lundquist. Back around to Buchnevich, then on to Trouba. Shook it off for Buchnevich again. Dealt it side of the net, the twirl and the try. Score! Initially Lemieux, but then it is poked home by D'Angelo. Nemeth to Lemieux, and he takes it right to the net. Hickets has to come over, and D'Angelo, all he's got for the carry by D'Angelo right up the wing. Buchnevich got it over, Kreider there, score! Two Red Wings go to one side of the ice, leaves the ice wide open on the other side, and off the skate, short side. You wouldn't mind Taco maybe shooting the puck one time on that. Shot, deflected, score! Another power play goal, and it is 3-0. Here tonight already from Adam Fox on the back end. He's got a real knack for getting pucks to the net. You could see it in the first period. That one was going wide, but when you put it towards the net, good things happen, and Strome takes it right off the shoulder. No chance. Reaching in is Filppula. Puck came out near Hickens. Fed along now for Filppula to start out in a 2-on-1 to Athanasiou. He's able to step right by. Got it across to Filppula. He scores!
Filppula and put it home and get the Red Wings back on the board.
Now comes McKegg moving in shorthanded. McKegg a shot, flexed away and high by Howard. Picked up by McKegg, he scores!
Stick. And Howard has no idea where this puck is, and by the time he finds it, it's in front of the net for McKegg, and he's not able to get down on the ice.
Wow. But now it is outletted ahead, and here comes Panarin with the net empty. He scores! The New York Rangers have won 3 of 4.
That's all the announcements we have for you today.
On behalf of WCVH, I'm Nina.
Alongside Bethany.
And this is CV Today.
Have a thumbs up Thursday.
Oh, I love you, but I can't.